Euron Trueblade is an evocator of the Celestial Vindicators. Vengeful like the rest of his brethren, he exists to destroy the forces of chaos. In this video, we're going to show how to paint this model. We're going to be painting it in the classic method and up to battle ready. But the first thing we'll need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've undercoated the model with Macragge Blue, which is perfect for the Celestial Vindicators colour scheme. Now the first colour we're going to be using is Thousand Suns Blue. So I'm going to get my medium base brush and apply some of that onto my palette, like so. A little touch of water, and then we're ready to start painting. Now this is going to concentrate on the armor. So all I'm going to do is you don't really need to do much. Just one thin coat should be enough with this, with the blue undercoat. Now, if you don't have Macragge Blue, you can always undercoat it black or gray, and then just base coat by hand. But you'll need to do a couple of coats of Thousand Suns Blue when doing that. With the armor now done, we're going to move on to applying some more base coats. Now we're going to start by picking out the red robes. For this, we'll be using Mephiston Red. Any gold details, we'll be using Retributor Armor. For the silver, we'll be using Ironhand Steel. Any black details, such as the tabard and some of the leather work, we'll be using Corvus Black. Then white emblems and the shoulder pads, we'll be picking out with Celestial Grey. And then finally after that, for the weapon hats, we'll be using Screamer Pink. But first of all, let's start with Mephiston Red. So again, we're just going to be applying a little bit to the palette. Now I'm using a medium layer brush for this, because I obviously want to get a nice point. I need to be a bit neater as well. So now that I've slightly thinned it down, I'm just going to get my brush to a nice point like so. Just twist it around a couple of times and I'm ready to start picking out those robes. So you've got a couple of areas. You've got the skirt and you've also got his sleeves. Now leave the inside of the actual robe or skirt, because we'll be picking that out with Celestial Grey later on. The next colour we're going to apply is Retributor Armour. This is going to be to all the gold details. So things like the shoulder trim, the trim just around the front chest plate, his sword hilt, and a little bit on the stave as well. There we are, with all those gold details now completed, we're going to move on to using Ironhand Steel to paint any silver details. So you're looking at the sword, the top of the stave, and also he's got a little bit of chain just on his back. Just paint that in that colour. You might want to do a couple of thin coats as well, just to remove some of that blue showing through. With all those silver details now picked out, we're going to move on to using Corvus Black to pick out any black details. These are things like the tabard on the front, the plume, and any leather joints such as like belts and also the bits in between the armour. With the black done, we're now going to move on to using Celestial Grey to pick out any white details. So you're looking at the shoulder pads and any emblems, so the emblems such as ones just on the tabard here and also around the back of his sleeves. Also using Celestial Grey, you want to pick out any vials as well. And the last colour to apply to our figure before moving on to the base is Screamer Pink, and this is going to be for the weapon hafts. There we are, with most of the base coats now applied to the model, we're just going to finish him off by picking out some of the details on the base. Now we're going to start the Mechanica Standard Grey for the stonework, and then we're going to use Deathwood Forest for any leaves. But first of all, let's start using that Mechanica Standard Grey. So I'm just going to apply some to my palette like so. Use a little bit of water. Now you see I'm using a medium base brush as well, just because it's quite a large area I'm going to be covering. So once I've loaded the brush up, we're ready to start picking out those details. So actually with the base itself, I'm going to cover the whole thing in Mechanica Standard Grey, including the leaves and the soil, and I'll just pick the leaves out after. With the stonework now picked out, we're going to be using Deathwood Forest to pick out all those leaves. And for this, I'm using a medium layer brush. There we are, with all those base coats now applied, we're going to move on to applying some shades. Now we're going to start with Reichland Flesh Shade, this is going to be used on the gold. After that we'll be using Aggrat's Earth Shade, this will be mainly for the red robes and also all the details on the base. And finally after that we'll use Norn Oil for everything else. So let's start with Reichland Flesh Shade. So I'm going to continue using my medium layer brush here. Just apply a little bit like that, get a nice point to my brush as well. Again, try not to overload when using shades because you don't want to start pooling. So I'm going to be picking out the gold, so this is like key actually to have less on your brush, because obviously the gold is more of a fine detail. So just start applying that all the way around. And if you do find you've splodged, just use your base coats to re-tidy back up. Next, we're going to apply an Aggrat's Earth Shade to all the robes and to the base. When doing the robes, try and be as neat as you can. If you do make any mistakes, just tidy back up with those base paints again. With the Aggrat's Earth Shade now applied and dry, we're going to start applying Norn Oil to all those areas that have not yet been touched by a shade. Now for the armor, we're just going to drop into the recesses, where any other details that have not been covered with a shade, we can just coat all over. And there we are, with the rim of the base now painted with a Baden Black, Euron Trueblade is battle ready. Now there are a couple of things to remember when painting this model. First, when using base paint, try and be as neat as you can. Remember, the neater you are, the better the end result. And if you do make any mistakes, you can just tidy back up at the end. And secondly, when using shade paints, try and be as neat as you can and try not to overload your brush, because it can quickly run out of control. If you do find this happening, just use a brush to soak up any excess. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoyed painting your own battle-ready Celestial Vindicators, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.